Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Ixa, and today I will be doing a get ready with me video. So if you'd like to see how I get ready today, just keep on watching. So I'm gonna start off with doing my eyebrows. Usually that's how I like to do my makeup. I usually like to start off with my eyebrows, go with my eyes, and then my foundation. A lot of people like to do it differently. Personally, this way works for me. So right now I'm using the Kat Von D 24 Hour Eyebrow Pomade. And I already brushed down my eyebrows to how I want them to lay. And now I'm just gonna outline the bottom of my brow. You know, you can bring it down as long as you want it to be. I like mine like right about there. And then I'm gonna outline the top part. But if you see, I try to not like really focus on the front area because you want that part to be a little bit more natural looking. And then, you know, fill in that little arch. And then just start filling in. With the product that I already have on the brush, I'm just going in and filling it in. So I don't want them to look so harsh. So once I'm done with that, I just blend it out with the spoolie. So now I just go to the eyebrow and I do the same thing. So now I'm gonna go in with the Sephora Make No Mistakes High Coverage Concealer to clean up those eyebrows. And like I said, this concealer is pretty full coverage, so I just put a little bit on the back of my hand, and if I need some more, I'll just go in and grab some more. That's usually how I like to do, because sometimes, a veces que where I like, agarro un chingo de producto, y luego I don't even use it, and it's just like a waste. And girl, you know, makeup ain't cheap. So now I'm just kind of like raising my eyebrows because I feel like, I don't know, it makes it easier for me to get like old, like underneath on here and shit. I don't know. And now I'm doing the top part. And I'm just using this e.l.f. brush that I got out. I don't know if it was CVS. I think it was for like $2, $3. I don't know. If you guys haven't tried e.l.f. brushes, you should try them. They're like really nice and they're cheap. Like, I got this brush right here, and I used it like a foundation brush or a blending brush, whatever. And I feel like it's really nice and it was super cheap. And I just go in with my ring finger and just kind of like blend it out myself. And let's go for those of you that you can. Now that I've done my eyebrows, Kat Von D, this is a primer and a corrector. I'm gonna prime with this, and then let's see. I don't know yet what to do. All I know is that I want a red lip. I was thinking of doing like a glitter liner, but I don't know. Maybe I haven't been feeling liner, and I don't know what the deal is. We'll just see what comes out. So I just put some on the back of my hand, and I'm just gonna put that all over the lid with my ring finger. So now I'm gonna be using the Morphe 35N palette. I'm gonna use this shade right here to set it. I don't know what just happened. I was filming and then it just stopped. So I just went in with this shade and I just kind of like, I don't know, there's some of the crease and blot it out a little bit. Now I'm gonna go in with the darker brown. It's right here. And do that on the outer. Blend, blend, blend. bringing it up a little bit up here too. And I'm gonna use this Smashbox Cover Shot Matte Eyeshadow Palette. And then I'll use this shade right here. And then I'm gonna do that like on the lid. And I'm just using this Sephora blending eyeshadow brush to pack that on here. I might use another brush, but I don't know. Yeah, I'm not really liking this brush. Just gonna use this. It's more like of a flat brush. So I'm gonna just use this here instead. I'm gonna go back in with that brush that I was using. And just blend this in right here. I might do some black. Maybe I should do some black. I'm gonna do a darker brown. Why does this have to be so complicated? Trying to figure out what you want to do. I'm gonna use this shade right here from the Flirt Tarte palette. This palette smells like chocolate. Have you guys smelled the peach palettes? Those smell good as well. I'm gonna use this with going with this little fluffy brush and just kind of blend it now. What y'all think? I don't think I wanna add black actually. Now that I'm thinking about it. No, go in with another flat brush and or let me finish up this other eye before I do all that. Damn, we didn't have it already. I'm gonna go to my grandma's house and eat some pozole. What do you guys have for New Year's Eve? I feel like a lot of people have like New Year's Eve is more for like partying, and then I feel like the Mexicans, it's kind of like another, like a second Christmas. Well, besides not getting the gifts or whatever, but like just getting together. And by now I'm just using that lighter shade that I used for this right here for the lid, and I'm putting that. Blending it out on the top so we don't look crazy. I don't know about you guys, but like when I'm going through it or whatever, I like talk to myself and I try to like motivate myself, like, no girl, get your shit together. Like, things are gonna work out. Stop stressing. And all that good shit. It helps. If you haven't done it, you should try to do it. You don't have to talk to yourself out loud, but I mean, if you want to, you can. I usually just kind of like talk to myself in my head. That kind of sounds crazy, but it works. So call me crazy. And I'm gonna use the Anastasia highlighter. Look how beautiful it is. And I'm gonna do that underneath the brow bone, or underneath the eyebrow on the brow bone. Yeah, that's how that works.
Right there, girl. Put your highlight on, you know, popping.
Tuck that bitch, because you don't want it to look too crazy. Every time you're gonna grab some powder product, tap it, girl, tap. Because you don't want it to look, I feel like that looks crazy. What's going on? Come on. Don't play with me tonight. What you doing? You know what? I haven't really been up doing my makeup like I should have. And I feel like ever since I haven't been doing my makeup all like that, like I feel like I don't know what I'm doing. Like my makeup doesn't look good. And do you guys have those times where you just feel like, fuck, my makeup does not look good tonight? Okay, so now that I've done that, I'm gonna do my eyeliner. Oh yeah, this is the new eyeliner I got, the roller liner by Benefit. It's like the roller lash mascara, but it's the eyeliner. Super cute, and it's pretty good. So we're just gonna go and do the next one. You ever have those days where like you do one eyeliner and then you're like, oh, this looks nice. Then you go to do the other one and then it doesn't come out. So then you gotta do the other one a little bit thicker. And then you gotta do the other one a little bit thicker. And then by the end, you're like, yo, what the fuck did I just do? Yeah, yeah, that's me all the time. So this is the mascara that I'm using, the CoverGirl, the Supersizer Big Curl. And this is the brush that it has. It's like a super big, big brush. I'm just gonna put this on before I apply my lashes. So I'm gonna use these lashes. I'm so excited about these lashes. I'll leave the link below so that you can check out their lashes. Also, if you use my code GLAMTIME, you get 10% off your purchase. So if you're looking for some super long gorgeous lashes, check them out. I'm using this duo brush on glue, and I'm gonna let that dry for like a couple seconds. Okay, so now lash time. I'm like excited about these. I don't know about y'all, but if I like lean over like this and like place my mirror the way I have it, it like helped me so much with like the eyelash application. Like it's so easier than actually like, I don't know, than like putting it like just like this. Like go like this. So like it's easier. So if you guys have trouble like applying lashes, like if you're looking down like this, I feel like it's so much easier. Try it out. And I'm using the Cover FX mattifying primer. This one's really nice. It does keep you matte all day and also like helps your makeup stay on longer. But what's cool about it is that it has like acne treatment in it, so it's gonna help with any acne you might have going on or help prevent acne as well. So just go ahead and rub it all on. Oh, I had already moisturized before we started this look. I used the Drunk Elephant Marula oil with the Purity moisturizer, just because I feel like I've been super dry lately and I just want to be moisturized. So I'm gonna use my Born This Way foundation. This is actually the first time I'm gonna try it out, see if it's good. I'm in the shade Natural Beige. I've heard so many good reviews about this, but I don't know, I just had it in the drawer and I haven't used it. And I was like, you know what? New year, new foundation, what's up? So, let's see what the hype's all about. And then I'm just gonna blend it out with that e.l.f. brush. This one right here. We'll be right back.
squeeze it. And squeeze it with my piggyback. It's hungry, my nigga. You need to feed it. If the text ain't freaky, I don't wanna read it. And just to let you know, this punani is undefeated.
Does like everybody always like highlight and contour with cream? So do you guys usually use like a powder? I feel like I used to do a lot with powder. Like when I first started highlighting and contour, I would do like a lot with powder, and then now it's either like I do cream or I don't really do it at all. Although cream can be a little bit harder just because you gotta make sure que pues you blend it in right. And then I'm using this Sephora foundation and concealer stick, and I'm just using this to like contour. I'm using the number 15. And I'll just do a little bit of here. Right here. A little bit on the forehead, because I mean, I already don't really have a forehead, so you don't need too much. Now, if you have a bigger forehead, not trying to be funny or rude or whatever, sure. You would just put more brown on the forehead to make it look smaller. Now I'm gonna bake with this Kat Von D Lock-It Highlight, no, brightening powder. Then I'm gonna go in with this bronzer. And this one kind of has more of like a shimmer to it. That's why I wanna use this, because I wanna look glowy. Then I'm gonna use the Anastasia highlighter. This is like my favorite highlighter. You guys haven't tried it? Girl, you need to go get one. Just wait on it. Like, look at that. I'm just gonna go in with this e.l.f. brush, and I'm gonna put some in the inner corner of my eye. Go in with that shade that I used from this palette, the darker shade. I'm gonna use this shade and this shade right here, these two underneath. Now I'm gonna add some hot mascara, not highlighter, at the bottom. I'm gonna be using this red Sephora lipstick. I just got this set for like $16. It was on sale, so basically like each one of them was like a couple bucks, and originally like each one is like $14. That's still not bad, because this is a really nice formula. It's comfortable and it's long wearing and it's matte. So you know how there's some mattes that are just like oof, I'm not trying to wear this, it's super dry, but these aren't like that. They just look really nice. Every time I wear this red, I get so many compliments. Then I'm gonna go ahead and set my face with the Cover Up Bags Illuminating Spray. Shake, shake, shake. Now I'm gonna go ahead and go do my hair, and I'll be back.
I'm back, guys. I went ahead and finished up my hair, and
I don't know how I feel about this curly fro, but I'm rocking it. So here's the final look. Turned out pretty good for me not knowing what I was gonna do at first. So super natural, glowy look with just a bold lip. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video.